1, 2, 3, probando, probando. Okay, so we are ready, yeah? Hello, my name is Bridget Perez, FLACA youth, also known as La Flaca. La Flaca, yeah? So in today's video, guys, I'm gonna be talking about how to really get started into drawing. For me, drawing opens opportunities to become confident in composing scenes, choosing subjects, and creating finished artworks. Maybe you have something there that you haven't finished yet because you don't feel really comfortable with it, but you don't know that, you actually don't know that maybe that piece is really good, but because you're blocked or whatever, you don't see it, I guess. So how do you actually start drawing? So for children, this is really easy. They just draw without hesitation, fear, and without anything that stops them. Like, they draw with enjoyment because they just want to capture what's in their mind into a piece of plain paper. So whether you're a beginner or more established artist like me, kinda, yeah, you can still improve. So do I. So in order to find confidence drawing, you just have to be patient. You have to practice, because practice is a key. So along this channel, I am gonna teach you how to be an expert using the monochrome of pencil and charcoal to the multicolored world of pastel and another medium. Yeah. So where do you begin? Well, all you need is just pencil and paper. That's all you need. No rubbers. Rubbers are not allowed for now, yeah? Like, until I say. Well, not until I say, but. So, yeah. Pencil and paper. You don't need rubber. No, no. So, you see my hand, yeah? I'm holding the pencil in the middle because you don't want to be making a hard line. If you hold the pencil too close to the graphite, then you're gonna be making really hard lines. And I know you're keen to draw and to make these beautiful lines, but wait, hold on. First of all, you need to draw your composition first. Draw your composition just like I did at the beginning. I was making marks, like composing, I don't know if that's the word, yeah, but I was placing all my details, not details, but like the volume of what I was gonna draw. That's what you have to do, yeah. Also, you have to bear in mind the measurements. You have to have in mind that there are measurements, so there are rules. And there's perspective, there's viewpoint, there's viewpoint, yeah. But don't worry, I will teach you that in the next video. Yeah. So once you have your composition, like a rough sketch of what you want to draw and with the measurements exactly, then is when you start making harder lines, and then it's when you can use your rubber, darling. You can delete now stuff that you don't want. But yeah, another advice is that if you want to start drawing something simple, like simple shapes. Could be a still life. If you don't know what is a still life, is just any boring object you have at home. Like, it could be your chair, table, anything. It also, like a perfume, something small, right? Or nature. That's also really, like, really easy. Not easy, but you've seen the shape, so your mind, you're from, I don't know the word, but you know how to draw it, because you know the shape. If you close your eyes, you can draw it, like, you know the shape, right? So you want to start with something familiar to you. That's the rule. Okay, so my advice would be go to your room, kitchen, anywhere in your house, and take an object that you see every day and draw it. But you have to like it, because if you take something you don't like, then your drawing is going to be awful, because you didn't like it, you didn't enjoy drawing. So when I was doing this painting, I really loved it. I was enjoying it, because that's my house from Spain. So that's what you have to do: find an object that you really, really want to draw or that you enjoy. But it has to be simple, so you don't stress yourself. You have to be realistic. Think. First, you have to do baby steps, and then you can run. Yeah. Okay. So thank you for today's video, guys. Thank you for watching. And if you like it, don't forget to subscribe and give thumbs up. And I'll be posting a video next week. Right now I'm doing Mondays at around 6 p.m. or maybe 8 p.m. But yeah. And remember, guys, always use first soft lines to draw your composition. Then you do the detail. And after that you paint. And same with the painting. You use a background color first. And then you put the base colors. And then you will start making detail just like I did. And I'll be explaining more things about painting in my next videos. Any comments, just drop them below here in the box. I will be replying to all of you, and thank you so much. Bye, take care, have a good day, and have a good weekend. So remember, I've got Instagram, which is La Flaca Arts. I have my personal account as well, Brigitte Perez, and also I've got Facebook, so follow me, and thank you. She don't call to say she love me, she just flex and started to tell me that I'm riding around in my car's low.